Okay. Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Maxime Nambier from Photonics Research Group of Ghent University, and I will present today my research results on gallium phosphide hybrid integration using transfer printing for nonlinear photonics. This work is a collaboration with Université Libre de Bruxelles, Institut Photon, and Centre de Nanoscience et de Nanotechnologie. In the past decade, the interest for integrated photonics has drastically increased, but there is still not a clear consensus on what is the best material for nonlinear application. In this context, large bandgap 3-5 semiconductors remain promising materials because they show a large second and third order nonlinearity combined to a large range of transparency. Recently, researcher teams focused on gallium phosphide as a new integrated nonlinear platform. For example, in this paper, the authors show the hybrid integration of gallium phosphide on an insulator layer in order to demonstrate the second harmonic generation. However, the process flow developed in this work consisting into a gallium phosphide membrane releasing, trapped in a water droplet and deposit on a host substrate, is not really scalable. Furthermore, the potential of the platform is still far away from its optimum in terms of loss management compared to other work present in the literature using, for instance, aluminum nitride or lithium niobate and showing a stronger nonlinear conversion efficiency. In another work, gallium phosphide is integrated on an insulator layer with the method of dice to wafer bonding. In this case, the propagation loss are lower and are around 1 dB per centimeter. I would like to mention at this point that it does not exist a chemical solution allowing to selectively remove a gallium phosphide substrate on top of an aluminum gallium phosphide sacrificial layer, making this work non-trivial to realize. Then the author, as you can see here on the picture, developed a substrate removal technique based on a dry selective etching. They finally show the generation of a Kerr frequency comb based on third order nonlinear effect, doubled by the second order nonlinear, nonlinearity. The process flow developed in this work is scalable, but asks for a large footprint of expansive gallium phosphide material. It also limits the possibilities for complex system fabrication using hybrid integration. In order to obtain a scalable gallium phosphide platform with decent optical properties, we will present today a new method for gallium phosphide integration by using the transfer printing technique. But let me first briefly introduce some basic concepts about microtransfer printing. The printing consists into the fabrication of 3-5 source coupons, which are released and maintained suspended with mechanical tether. The coupons can be picked up with a polymer stamp and print on a target wafer. Transfer printing shows some benefits, such as a low 3-5 material footprint consumption, a high degree of flexibility for hybrid integration, an accurate alignment below 1 micrometer, the possibility to print arrays of coupons, and a fast printing cycles around 1 minute. We can see on the teaser picture the transfer printer that we have at Ghent University. Here are some examples of printed devices showing the versatility of the technique and showing different possibilities of light coupling in a printed device. The first one is a hybrid silicon nitride laser with a printed 3-5 SOA used as a gain medium. These kinds of lasers can operate in the continuous wave or pulse mode regime, depending if the SOA possesses a saturable absorber or not. In this case, the light is coupled from the silicon nitride circuit into the SOA via adiabatic tapers. Another device showing is a lithium niobate modulator. So here is the modulator, print on a silicon nitride photonic circuit. The mode propagating in the circuits can partially overlap the lithium niobate printed membrane, and this is how the light is coupled into the device. The last one is a fast unit traveling carrier photodetectors allowing for hyperfrequency wave generation. The device is directly printed on top of the output grating coupler of the host circuit. We can mention that in all of those examples, the metallic contact pads, so here, 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 and here, have been patterned post-printing. I will now present the heart of my talk, which is a novel process flow developed for transfer printing of gallium phosphide. The process starts with the fabrication of the source coupons on the gallium phosphide material stack. So here is the stack. And a lithographic process combined to dry and wet etching is used to access the substrate. So this step. Then the coupons are encapsulated in a second amorphous silicon layer. And at this point, the tether, so the tether can be patterned. At this point, the coupons can be released in a chemical solution, highly selective for the gallium phosphide, aluminum gallium phosphide system. And the coupons can be picked up with a polymer stamp and print on the host circuits. The last step consists into the amorphous silicon etching, which is a selective etching, in order to obtain a thin gallium phosphide on insulator layer ready to be patterned. Here is a picture of the target fabricated by metal deposition on top of an oxidized silicon substrate. The gold marker will serve for printing alignment. On the second picture, we can see the target after printing of the coupons on top of it. And finally, on the last picture, we can observe a gallium phosphide on insulator layer after amorphous silicon removal. The second step of the process is to pattern waveguides on top of the gallium phosphide print layers. This is done with the classic e-beam lithography technique. The patterns are first transferred into an oxide hard mask and then into the gallium phosphide layer. The hard mask is finally removed in a selective chemical solution. And the device are ready to be measured. Here I show some picture of the fabricated device. So you can see several printed coupons already patterned. And we can also see in the middle picture the magnification on a ring resonator and the magnification on a grating coupler fabricated in a gallium phosphide layer. On the SEM picture, we can also see the sidewall quality after the gallium phosphide dry etching. In order to estimate the optical quality of our platform, we measure the resonance lines of the micro resonator. The results for wavelengths in the telecom range are presented in the figure. Here we subtract the insertion losses coming from the grating coupler, which are around 15 dB per grating. The measured free spectral range corresponds in this case to the T00 fundamental mode resonances. The resonances are then fit using a model of ring resonator transmission. And the fitted parameters are the coupling ratio R and the loss factor A. A and R. The ring shows a Q factor of 40,000 at the critical coupling when we have A almost equal to R, corresponding to propagation loss as low as 5 dB per centimeter. As a proof of concept, we will try to measure second harmonic generation in our transfer print and ring resonators. Here I will briefly show what is the second harmonic generation process. So this consists into the combination of two photons at the frequency omega into one photon at frequency 2 omega via a virtual level in a material showing a second order nonlinear susceptibility. In order to obtain an efficient conversion efficiency, the phase matching condition needs to be respected. The difference between both propagation constants for the fundamental and second harmonic modes need to be equal to zero in the case of modal phase matching condition in a straight waveguide, or need to be equal at 2 divided by the ring radius R for a microring resonator. As an example, we show here modal and quasi-phase matching condition for pump photon in the T00 fundamental mode and a second harmonic photon in the TM00 mode. So here is the modal phase matching condition, and here are both quasi-phase matching condition. In the reality, many phase matching involving the fundamental T00 mode for the pump photons can be observed. So here is a map showing all the modal phase matching for second harmonic higher order mode in a sulfide platform as a function of the dimension of the waveguides. We finally tried to observe experimentally the second harmonic generation in our gallium phosphide ring resonators. And almost each resonant peak of a ring gives rise to second harmonic generation. So for each peak, you have second harmonic generation involving different quasi-phase matching conditions. In order to confirm the effect, we also measure the quadratic dependence of the second harmonic power as a function of the pump power. Unfortunately, we still don't know the absolute conversion efficiency because we don't know the grating coupler insertion loss for higher order second harmonic modes, but this work remains in progress. In conclusion, gallium phosphide is a promising material for integrated nonlinear photonics, and we have demonstrated the transfer printing of this material in order to take advantage of the versatility of this integration method. Waveguide loss of 5 dB per centimeter have been measured, and we also have shown first results of second harmonic generation in our platform. In future work, it should be possible to observe more nonlinear effects such as frequency combs and supercontinuum generation. And finally, hopefully the platform could be integrated on complex photonic circuits. Thank you very much for your attention, and I'm now waiting for your question. Thank you.